Thank you, Mr. President. You know, as I pondered what I would say today, I began to think about how so many times the messenger is in fact so big of a part of the message. And, you know, I wondered what benefit I could bring to this particular conversation because, after all, I'm a middle-aged, middle-class white male. Would any of my words actually resonate? You know, I've neither faced nor felt the pain and strife felt by Dr. King and so many others before, you know. So I began to re-listen to some of his speeches over the weekend and studying his words. And one speech in particular really just struck my heart, as I believe that his words then were just as relevant then as they are today. And so I've taken the liberty of using just a few of his words from a speech on April 3rd, 1968, and adapting them ever so slightly to current times. And his speech begins with an imagining of standing at the beginning of time with the possibility of taking a kind of a general and panoramic view of the whole of human history up to now. And he says, the Almighty said to him, Martin Luther King, which age would you like to live in? And Dr. King then replied, and he said, I would take my mental flight by Egypt, and I would watch God's children in their magnificent trek from the dark dungeons of Egypt through, or rather across, the Red Sea, through the wilderness and on toward the Promised Land. And in spite of its magnificence, he says, I wouldn't stop there. He says, I would move on by Greece and take my mind to Mount Olympus, and I would see Plato and Aristotle, Socrates, Euripides, and Aristophanes assemble around the Parthenon, and I would watch them around the Parthenon as they discussed the great and eternal issues of reality. But I wouldn't stop there, he says. He says, I would go on even to the great heyday of the Roman Empire, and I would see developments around there through various emperors and leaders, but I wouldn't stop there. I would come on up even to 1863 and watch a vacillating president by the name of Abraham Lincoln finally come to the conclusion that he had to sign the Emancipation Proclamation. But I wouldn't stop there, he says. I would come on up to the early 30s and see a man grappling with the problems of bankruptcy of his nation and come up with an eloquent cry that we have nothing to fear but fear itself. He said, but I wouldn't stop there, he says. Strangely enough, I would turn to the Almighty and I would say, and this is where I took a little liberty with his words, if you allow me to live just a few years in the first half of the 21st century, I will be happy. Now back to his words. He says, that's a strange statement to make because the world's all messed up. The nation is sick, trouble's in the land, confusion is all around. That's a strange statement, but somehow, I know that only when it's dark enough can you truly see the stars. Something is happening in our world, he said. The masses of people are rising up, and wherever they're assembled today, whether they're in New York, Chicago, Seattle, or Washington, D.C., the cry is always the same. We want to be free. We want righteousness and justice and equality to prevail. Mr. President, his words were true for such a time as his, and I believe they certainly remain true for such a time as ours. May God continue to bless the work of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. May God bless the ongoing works of this legislature, and may God bless the people of Washington State. Thank you.